Kira Chim, and I did this art piece to go with our theme, Dreams. This piece represents how Black women are the roots of our society, and how their role is significant to our development and understanding as humans.
Hello, I'm Kateri Murillo, and this piece is inspired by Jean-Michel Basquiat. And he started off as a graffiti artist, and his art quickly got noticed for its highlights on racial inequality, brutality, and injustice. This piece is inspired by Jean-Michel Basquiat, and it shows how the police force continues to put down Black people and minorities, and how they take advantage of their own power to continue putting labels on Black people and labeling them as crazy and out of control.
My name is Malachi Phillips. My painting was inspired by Jonathan. Okay. Tell them we're starting. I mean, I just want so many things sometimes that I think it's gonna drive me crazy. See, I'm 35 years old and I ain't got nothing. I ain't gonna be nothing, mama. Just look at me, look at me.
I'm looking at you, and you're a good looking young boy. You got a job, a fine wife.
A job? No, mama, you know what I do? I drive a man around his limousine all day, and you know what I say? I say yes, sir, and no, sir, and shall I take the drive, sir? Mama, that ain't no kind of job, that is nothing at all. I don't know if I can make you understand.
Understand what?
Well, I mean, sometimes I can just see my whole future spread out in front of me. My whole future, a big, blank, empty space just waiting for me at the edge of my days. But it doesn't have to be. Sometimes when I'm driving that man around, we pass them cool, quiet-looking restaurants. And I look in, I see these white boys. They sit talking deals. Deals worth millions of dollars, mama.
Son, why do you talk so much about money?
Because it's life.
Oh, so now money is life? Once upon a time, freedom used to be life, but now it's money?
It was always money. We just didn't know it.
Hi, Ray.
Hi.
We would like to welcome you to the Black History Month presentation of 2023, titled Dreams.
That scene you just saw was an excerpt of a play called A Raisin in the Sun by Lorraine Hansberry, and it's about dreams, obviously, since that's our title of the show. So, our performers have dreams. You guys have dreams. We all have dreams. We've worked really hard to put together this collection of dreams, actually. We have acting, poetry, rapping, fashion, and dancing, of course. So, we hope you guys enjoy the show, and our next act, I would like to introduce Adama Diona with a poem. And without further ado, I would like to welcome you guys to Dreams.
I will be reading Revolutionary Dreams by Nikki Giovanni.
I used to dream malevolent dreams of taking over America to show these white folks how it should be done. I used to dream radical dreams of blowing everyone away with my perceptive powers. I even used to think that I'd be the one to stop the riots and the fights and negotiate the peace. Then I awoke and dug that if I dream natural dreams of being a natural woman, doing what a woman does when she's natural, I would have a revolution.
Hey guys. All right, so since you're already familiar with who we are, I'll start to the point. So I have a trivia game, easy and simple rules. $1 is a super easy question. Easy question is 5, medium is 10, and hard/impossible is $20 reward. So we'll be taking 4 participants to help us out, and we'll be selecting. So if you want to play, please raise your hand. Thank you. Ain't no way.
What's your name?
Reno.
All right. Do you want a medium? super easy, easy, medium, or hard? What is George Washington Carver most known for?
Peanut butter.
Okay. Give him the easy. Yeah. Do you want, what's your name?
Gabby.
All right, do you want a super easy, medium, or hard?
Give me that super easy.
What is Martin Luther King's real name?
Martin Luther King Jr.?
Hey, yep, get it. All right. What's your name?
Brian.
All right, do you want a medium or hard?
Medium. Medium.
All right, what is the main difference between Malcolm X's arrest and Martin Luther King's arrest?
All right, so. No.
The difference in ideology.
So. Get me, can I forfeit?
Yeah, you can go.
Wait, go ahead and go. All right, what's your name?
Ira.
All right, do you, medium or hard? Do you want medium or hard?
What?
Do you want medium or, bro? Okay. Medium or hard?
Medium.
All right, what did Malcolm X go to jail for the first time?
I forfeit.
Yeah.
Reno will be taking the question for the community's sake to educate you peoples.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know the question. What did Malcolm X go to jail for the first time?
Just walking on the street.
He went to jail for sleeping with white women and robbery and like a long list of things.
Yeah, there's
And the difference in ideology, and the difference in ideology was one was for peace, one was any means necessary. Thank you.
Please welcome Destiny Hudson with her poem.
The power that's embedded in me is not a weapon, but a prize from my ancestors that proffered the beauty in me. With the same blood running from vein to vein, connecting to the same heart, why are we the ones tired? Tired of worrying about our black men making a home to cook dinner, our kisses goodnight with the fading smile reflecting on how to make it tomorrow. Or is there a tomorrow? What kind of tomorrow? Maybe the tomorrow we pray for before sleep. The kind where people who look like me cannot just be free, but free. You kill our black men and make fun of us for not having one because really you're afraid. Me too. Is my brother next? The world is a broken clock trying to pass time. Exhausted of us being angry black women before you even get to know our names. Say her name. Feel her name. Breonna Taylor. Behind the rumors and the misrepresentation, she deserved to live. As I walk into a room, the words ghetto, loud, and fatherless are plastered on my forehead. With my dark skin comes hate and responsibility. As I get older and my knowledge grows further, I must take 3 steps ahead, yet we get the same praise with no mercy among my mistakes. Take me serious, I deserve to be heard. Hear me out, not because I'm black or because this is where you have to be, but because I'm determined for you to see not the color, but the human in me. Black beauty is a powerful thing spreading across the earth with many different traits appealing to the eye. What is it that you hate? Our curls curve and flow, which each strand of hair naturally kinked with perfection, representing one of many different textures around the world. Our beautiful colored skin absorbs nutrients from the sun. As we darken from the sun, each shade gets more and more beautiful, representing us. If you didn't listen to anything, listen to this. The power that's embedded in me is not a weapon, but a prize from my ancestors that proffered the beauty in me.
Please welcome our guest speaker for today, our well-respected track coach, Coach Moraney.
Oh my goodness, how y'all doing? Can you take the spotlight off? That's too much light for me. But anyway, good afternoon, how y'all doing? Good. To those who may not know me, my name is Brian Moraney. I am an ordained Baptist preacher. I graduated from the University of Cincinnati with an accounting and finance degree. Accounting and finance degree. I've been working in hospital finance for over 40 years. And I've had 3 children to graduate from Finneytown High School. Olivia Moraney, Braxton Moraney, and my stepson, James Haskins. So I have been coaching here since 2004. So I've been around for a very long time. Now, I understand this is Black History, so let me ask you all a question. Does anybody know how Black History got started? Anybody? Yes, go ahead. How did Black History get started? okay? Well, just to let you know, Black History Month started from a vision from Dr. Carter G. Woodson in 1915. And what happened was he did a study of Negro history, and he discovered that Black history has been excluded from other American history. So in 1926, he developed what is at the time called Negro History Week. And the reason why he chose that specific week is because of the fact that that week coincided with two important birthdays, Abraham Lincoln, as well as, I wrote this down so I don't forget, as well as Frederick Douglass. As time went on, in 1976, it was expanded to a full month in honor of the bicentennial of the country, and it became Black History Month. It is not because they gave us the shortest month, okay? That's not true. It's because of the fact that Dr. Carter G. Woodson developed all of this history. We, Black folk, are part of American history. And he wanted to make sure that Black history was part of American history, not as a way of separating, but as a way of combining everybody to recognize the accomplishments. How many of y'all smoke cigarettes? Uh-huh. I knew that'll get you. How many people drive? Okay. Here we go. How many of y'all cut grass? There you go. Do you realize that all of those things was invented by a Black man? The first heart surgery was developed by Dr. Daniel Hale Williams in Chicago, a Black man. Granville T. Woods, he developed the gas mask. All of these men, all of these women of color developed all of these inventions, and they had this vision in mind, not just necessarily to put them out in Front Street, but to let other people have a better life. That gas mask that he developed was used and vital to the survival of World War I. As some of you all take history, know what happened during World War I. But a lot of things were made by Blacks. Anybody heard of Benjamin Banneker? Benjamin Banneker memorized the entire layout of Washington, D.C. because there was an argument between the French engineer and the Americans. And he took the plans with him, but Benjamin Banneker memorized it, and thus we have the whole entire layout of Washington, D.C. He also had the Farmer's Almanac. So there's a lot of things that Blacks have done that we may not necessarily know about. Now I'm going to get personal. All of these folks had visions. But the one thing that I did not mention, I am also a Prince Hall Mason. Prince Hall was the first Black initiated in the United States in 1775 by an Irish military lodge, and he became a Mason. What is so significant about that is that during the Revolutionary War, Prince Hall went to General George Washington, our first president, to try to petition to him to allow Blacks in the Revolutionary War, because at the time, Blacks were not allowed to fight for America. And he had to go and petition to allow Blacks in the Revolutionary War. And from him started what is now known as Prince Hall Masonry, and I'm also a Mason. He had a vision, and that vision has gone all through the entire world. Ohio became the first in Ohio. Here in Cincinnati, had his first Masonic Lodge, Prince Hall, in 1848. Let's move on. Have you all heard of the Divine Nine, Black fraternities and sororities? Give me some. What have you heard? What? The Divine Nine comprise of five fraternities and four sororities that were originated mostly from historically Black colleges. The first Black fraternity, of which I am a life member of, is Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. We were founded December the 4th, 1906. Yeah. That's to wake you up. Then from there, there was Kappa Alpha Psi, Omega Psi Phi Fraternity, and Phi Beta Sigma. But here's the thing. There was also some sororities. Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Sigma Gamma Rho, Z Phi B. Are there any AKAs in the audience? Are there any deltas in the audience? All right. I can't see that far. Anyway, the founders of all of those fraternities and sororities had a vision. So what I want to say to you this afternoon, each and every one of you all should have a vision for your life. Each and every one of you all should have a goal for your life. You should not come to school just to have fun, although it's good to have fun. Lord knows I had fun in school. But here's my point, guys. Black history is about those persons who sacrifice to make things better for you, for each and every one of you. Don't let their efforts go to waste. Learn something in school, because I'm here to tell you, I got 5 years to work, and I'll be on Social Security, and I need each and every one of y'all to find a job and work so that you can fund the Social Security and I can have a Social Security check every month in 5 years when I retire. But in all seriousness, each one of these folks had a vision. My challenge to you today is, what is your vision? What is it that you want to do with your life? And I heard somebody say, not much. Think about it. Think about it. You all have a good day.
Now please welcome Star Abbott with Burn.
Come on. Last time I almost fell off the stage, I hope it'll be
good. Scraping off the paint that was plastered on my black canvas, I wondered why people called it ugly. Maybe it's too dark, too scary, or were you angry that it wasn't plain? It wasn't the color you thought. The first thing you saw was its color black instead of the vibrant colors that surrounded it. Why is that all that you saw? You perceived it as ghetto, worthless, never able to succeed, but later with the same paint, make it a style. Only you use the white canvas. Scraping off the paint, it sizzles and burns. Me and the canvas are now both the same shade of black. Now we are beautiful, but I was before. I am me, a dreamer. My canvas is one of all shades.
We just wanna party.
Look how I'm kicking up.
Good afternoon, everybody. Hope you guys are enjoying the show. So,
how y'all doing today? Hey, that's good. That's good. How are you, Ray?
I'm really good today.
Would you like to tell the audience what we're doing here today?
Yes, actually. So, we have our second game here for you guys, and this game is called
Name That Tune.
Name That Tune, guys. All right. So, what we have is easy, medium, and hard. You will be guessing a black artist's music and the name. So the name of the song and the name of the artist. So, but I do warn you guys, we are picking from the audience, but I need you guys to know that it might not be that easy. So I need you to know your black culture and I need you to know your black songs, all right? So, who would like to go?
One more person. Can you please?
Yeah. Make a line over here, please.
Okay.
All right. I need everyone to quiet down, please. All right, so I'm going to let you guys know, once someone picks easy, medium, or hard, you cannot pick it again, all right? So be careful when I tell you what you want, all right? So you go first. You want easy, medium, or hard?
What's your name?
Omaria.
Easy, medium, or hard?
Easy.
Easy?
Okay, right. Play the easy track.
Shine bright like a diamond.
You gotta get the artist and the name.
Rihanna.
Okay.
Diamond?
Good job. Yeah. I'll give them all at the end. I'll give them all at the end. Okay. All right, so, Trey, what do you want?
Medium.
Medium? Play the medium track, please.
Put in the gutter, listen to me.
It's Waterfalls by.
Come on.
Somebody in the audience just said it. Oh, DOC? That was, oh, TOC. I'm tripping.
Yeah, you got it. All right. That means you got hard, Dominic, all right? So, please play the hard track.
It could all be so simple. But you rather make it hard.
Would you guys like to hear more? Can we play more, please?
It's like a battle. And we both end up with scars.
Would you like to phone a friend? All right. Okay, guys, he's phoning a friend. Calm down, calm down, calm down.
What's your name?
Alana Coleman.
Okay, do you know the song?
X Factor Lauryn Hill.
Yeah! Yeah, yeah. There you go. Did you choose easy? Or did you? Okay. The medium. They all got some gift cards, guys. All right.
Thank you.
So, we would like to now introduce our next act, a poem by DeMarco O'Brien. Please, everyone, give him a round of applause.
Hi again. Every thought, hold up. Ben, don't text me. Every thought of you echoes in my head, telling me what I can and can't be, who I am and what I've done. And like a child, I listened. Every time I listened, like a lamb lining up to be slaughtered. Dreams I thought I could achieve, never good enough. Things I wanted to be, always shot down. Things that you thought were perfect was always for you, but never for me. At least I had a dream, but my dreams wasn't the same as yours. And I learned that pretty quickly, that dreams change depending on the person and who you are. So, you know, just like them while you can, I guess.
Sounds, I hear you, man. Ocean. And it's it right here. Queen Bee, yeah. I'm the king. Y'all know that.
Ocean, baby.
She the queen. Came right back.
Yeah. Oh, remix.
Yeah, man.
Now, baby girl, there ain't nothing more that I can say. You know, by now I wanted more than anything. Stuck in my head like a melody.
I know you want it,
yeah.
But I'm hesitating.
Why?
You must be crazy. I got a man, you got a lady.
I know we here together, so this must be something special. You could be anywhere you want, but you decided to be here with me. No coincidence, it was meant to be. Don't be shy, gon' let your boy get in. So
remix. Let's go.
Hold on. Y'all thought it was gonna be over? Nah. We'll just get into the real good part. Let's go. Drop that beat.
I just had a dream. Yeah. FTL in the building. Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Hey. I just had a dream about my mama, a new Lambo truck. That day, cause I'm black, I had to stand there, put my hands up. Big dog, status song, leave without an answer. Got the crowd jumping out to put my pants up. Never like the option, that's the party sleeping. Big on their brutality, I hate that's where they gotta be. I ain't got that much power, but I speak, I know you hearing me. Yeah.
LFTH baby finna make a bang on this one.
Yeah. Hey, I need everybody to turn their lights on right now. Yeah. I just had a dream about my mama, a new Lambo truck. Then because I'm black, I had to stand and put my hands up. Big dog, status song, leave without an answer. Got the crowd jumping out to put my pants up. Never like the option, there's the party sleeping. Big on their brutality, I hate, that's what it gotta be. I ain't got that much power,
but I speak. I know you hearing me. This word is rude by Muddy Dale. Listen to the. They take all of our money, then they tell us get a job. Then we gotta pay the bills, don't got your space for a lot. Here we drowning, here we drowning. Tryna hold on to the struggle, but we drowning. Don't get money, but they tell us put the time in. You gon' listen, you gon' listen. You gon' listen, cause I know you hear me. You gon' listen, you gon' listen. You gon' listen, cause I know you hear me. You gon' listen, you gon' listen. You gon' listen, cause I know you hear me. You gon' listen, you gon' listen, you gon' listen, cause I know you. It's been a minute, I've been in it. I just dropped another album, I ain't finished. Don't believe a non-believer to my music. Make you feel it in your heart that I got people. Know some people, we some people, that some people, we some people. We better stand together. I know God has told us that we better stand this weather. Moving, we imperfect, but achieve much better. I'm a young homie, but they do what I say so. When a real leader, you gon' hit me when I say go. Touching in the window, tell them get down and you stay low. Put your hands behind your back and homie, I say hell no. Put your hands behind your back and it, I say hey, hey. I just had a dream, I bought my mama a new lamb truck. They need cause I'm black, I had to stand and put my hands up. Big dog started song, leave without an answer. Got the crowd jumping out the put my pants. Never like the option, that's the police sleeping big on their brutality. I hate that's where they gotta be. I ain't got that much power, but I speak, I know you hearing me. Who about money down, listen to the prophecy. They take all of our money, then they tell us get a job. Then we gotta pay the bills, don't got the space for a lie.
Here we drowning.
Tryna hold on to the struggle, but we drowning. Don't get money, but they tell us put the time in. You gon' listen, you gon' listen. You gon' listen, cause I know you hear me. You gon' listen, you gon' listen. You gon' listen, cause I know you hear me. You gon' listen, you gon' listen. You gon' listen, cause I know you hear me. You gon' listen, you gon' listen, you gon' listen, cause I know you hear me.
Please welcome the Boys and Girls Competition, Her Way Dance, Baby.
She bought a rock, saw a city cover. She wasn't on a run, and she wanted on a run up.
The early 90s and 2000s were cultivated by black fashion, going from Y2K to streetwear to high fashion. We will now present a fashion show inspired by all of that. Yeah.
With your black hair and your fat ass style. Street poetry is my everyday. But yo, I gotta stop when you drop my weight. If I was was working at the club, you would not pay. Ayo, my man Fife Diggy, he got something to say.
I like him brown, yellow, Puerto Rican, and Haitian. Name is Fife Dog from the Zulu Nation. Told you in the jam that we could get down. Now let's knock the boots like the group H-Town. You got DVD all on your bedroom wall, but I'm above the rim and this is how I ball. A gritty little something on the New York street. This is how I represent over this here beat. Talking about you.
Yo, I took you out, but sex was on my mind for the whole damn route. My mind was in a frenzy in a horny state, but I couldn't drop dimes cause you couldn't relate.
You let yourself
go, please. You couldn't relate. You couldn't relate.
I would like to thank everybody for coming out tonight. Now, I wanna give. Wait. I wanna give thanks to some people, all right? I wanna give thanks to Miss Miller, my seventh grade English teacher, who she left, she did leave, but she started this program. She's the reason we're doing this, all right? I would like to give thanks to both of the Miss Kellys, who have helped us do this. And especially thanks to Miss Walker, who took up the mantle to help us program this whole thing. Thank you, Miss Walker. We all love you. Thank you all for coming out tonight.
We could do like Uncle Ella, swing it up in my Jeep. Keep it on the down, yo, we keep it discreet. See, I'm not the type of kid to have my business.